Thank you. Now we are almost at the close of the first half. Many people have to fly early, so I've been getting repeated requests for Dr. Gore's session. Before that, let me get Dr. Aroop Mukharjee. Both of his talks are very widely awaited. Again, don't worry if you miss the prescriptions. You will get a PDF of these talks possibly by tonight itself, with a complete list of medicines, including the prescription that he gives in his own hands. And both of these interesting talks, even I am very keen and anxious to learn. Dr. Aroop Mukherjee.
Good afternoon, friends, and our younger colleagues. Yeah, thank you. Now, in the afternoon today, I will be discussing something which most of us, as an orthopedic surgeon, have confronted or are facing in our day-to-day practice. So, this is a quite an interesting thing that will enhance your observations so that you don't make your patient suffer and suffer yourself as well. Because when there is no fracture healing, then we don't want to see the patient. And patient has got very difficult questions to answer. So let me try to sort out some of those silent and hidden things which has been based on my observations, that why doesn't this fracture heal? Now, what are the known methods? Known methods we are not discussing. We have all done our graduation, post-graduation, and we know all these things with the click of a button these days, that we can find out what has gone wrong. But just recapitulate again. A good fixation, what we know, did we use bone graft? Third thing is nutritional supplements. Avoiding bisphosphonate and corticosteroids. If the patient is already on these things, be careful to undertake these patients for surgical endeavors. Creative conducive atmosphere for healing. PTH, parathyroid hormone administration, and platelet rich plasma. But platelet rich plasma I have never used, but it is in the literature. And many centers in the country, and there are some agencies as well who will come and collect that the patient's blood and will give you platelet-rich plasma for the use. Now, potential risk for the non-union, there are two groups. One is a modifiable groups, and another is a non-modifiable groups. If we recollect what is a modifiable groups, that substance abuse, if the patient is a smoker, you write it down on the prescription. On your presentation, patient known smoker, alcoholic. Because these are not a proper candidate for a proper biological healing. So they will take their own time to heal. So if you warn them beforehand, in presence of the attendant, their wife or parents, that is better for your safety. After listening to the medico-legal implication, you have heard that. Now, medication used, if the patient has been taking too much of NSAID and steroids, then also it is a hindrance problem. So give only NSAIDs for 5 days, 4 days, soon after surgery, soon after injury, that's it. Not beyond that. If the patient is in pain, you should be alert that something is going wrong. Now, potential risk is again infection. All the compound fractures have a potential to go to non-union, not even because of the severity of injury, but because of the potential infection risk. And infection will never allow the bone to heal, or it is delayed. Systemic diseases like diabetes or inadequate surgical fixation. Now, inadequate surgical fixation means, again, there is a potential risk for going into non-union. So these are the known, and this can be modified. Now, this is metabolic deficiencies, when we are talking about, then you should be every fracture patient, if you think that it is important for you to know a vitamin D injection, I usually give in my practice. But if the patient doesn't want an injection of you, then you suggest vitamin D estimation. If vitamin D estimation is 2000 rupees, it is expensive for most of the patients. So either they should get it done or they should get the injection. One injection of vitamin D practically gives you a rise of 20 to 30 nanogram per ml in practical senses. So if the patient has got 8 or 10 nanogram, which we very commonly see these days, one injection will give a rise of only 40 nanogram per ml. And I practically advocate nearly 100 nanogram per ml of vitamin D level in any patient who is undergoing a fracture treatment. Now, hyperparathyroidism, if there is a chronic vitamin D deficiency, then there will be relative hyperparathyroidism, and hyperparathyroidism will also cause non-unions. Deficiencies of hormone like testosterone, hypothyroidism, very common these days. So women suffering from anemia, hypothyroidism, acidity, they are very prone candidate for going into a delayed union. And of course, they have a secondary osteoporosis. Now, nutritional deficiencies and malabsorption. Nutritional deficiencies does not mean that only poor will have it. Even rich people have nutritional deficiencies because of the bowel inflammation, which is associated with hypothyroidism. What does hypothyroidism causes? Hypothyroidism causes poor gut motility, and a poor gut motility causes a condition which is called in short form SIBO, S-I-B-O. This is small, stands for small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, which gives a negative impact to the immune system of the patient, and the patient will have a higher CRP, higher ESR for no reason. Fever, patient is not having any fever or constitutional symptom, but because of the higher CRP and ESR, these patient will go into a delayed union or even a non-union. So your job is not to be get carried away with a poor patient that he is only having malnutrition. Now, suggest according to the age and metabolic condition. If the patient is 60, 70, 80 year old, everything will not be digested. You cannot say chicken khao, mutton khao, this and that, because his digestion is impaired. You have to give selective food in order to improve his hemoglobin, enhance his digestion, because we need good nutrition in order to get his fracture healed, because he's already suffering from osteoporosis. Osteoporosis has happened because of malnutrition, which has been existing for the past many years. So there is a gut atrophy, and because of the presence of gut atrophy, I would always suggest any woman, any man plus 50, 60 years of age with the risk of malnutrition should be suggested whey protein or the commercial available, like what we feed our children, like Complan, give Protein X, give Ensure, give GRD sugar. Some people are very finicky about sugar. I am diabetic, I cannot take these blends. It doesn't make any difference whether you take a cup of take a spoon of sugar in your tea, you are diabetic, but it is in their mind. So I said, all right, there are some available brands which are also sugar-free, like GRD sugar-free, Protein X sugar-free, you can take that. But never miss on supplement, protein supplement, digestible according to the age of the patient. So for a young man, you can say, you can take anything to supplement the protein. For old people and for people who are you suspect are suffering from malnutrition. Now, this is a picture of 55-60 year old person with clear cut malnutrition. See, the bones have become, at one stage the bones have become soft, and this is a triradiate pelvis. The acetabulum has head of the femur has dug in. You can see those coarse trabeculae, And after certain age, when his nutritional requirement is so, he has come, is less, he has come into this stage. So this is a classical case of nutritional deficiency, pain-free. But if he sustains a fracture, it will be difficult for us. We have to promote union. Now, non-modifiable risk, the second group was non-modifiable, which we can't do anything about, is injury pattern. He has already come with a certain injury pattern, like very bad comminuted fracture, large pieces of bone are avascular and lying here and there. Location of the fracture, in which the fracture is located at some places where the blood supply is poor, severe bone loss. Now, the patient is suffering already from certain diseases which will hamper his healing, peripheral vascular diseases, age-related debilitating diseases. Now, if the patient is not mentally cooperative to the treatment, like Parkinson's, he can't help because of his inadvertent movement, abnormal movement, mental instability, poor family support. If the patient is living alone, you can't expect that he will, it will be very difficult for him to look after himself with a fracture. Now, mental depression and people with low esteem. I have seen so many elderly people who don't want, they will say that this is nearly the end of their life and they don't want to live alone. They have got a poor, low self-esteem, and it is very difficult to institute a treatment for them. So we are just not telling you anything, just reminding you of these things. Please consider these before taking a fracture patient. So many things we need to learn before taking a patient for surgical treatment. Fracture healing. Now, any medicine, anything which we need to supplement the patient with should affect with these four phases of fracture healing. Now, if the first is an inflammatory phase, which lasts for 3-4 days, early callus phase, then mesenchymal cell go into the cartilage, and the third is a mature callus phase, and fourth is a remodeling phase. Now, where does this affect? If the patient is on bisphosphonate or has a history of taking of a bisphosphonate, the fourth remodeling phase get affected, because bisphosphonate will affect the function of osteoclast, and this osteoclast will be will not be able to remodel and remodel the fracture and causing delay in the fracture healing. Mature callus phase means there is a mobility of lot of minerals and calcium towards the bone, and we need to give supplement vitamin K and other and as well as calcium to these patients, so that the immature callus goes into the mature callus state, in which there is a deposition. Now, this is the phase also in which we need to give parathyroid hormone in a pulse form in a regular way to enhance the deposition of minerals and calcium into the bone. Early callus phase, that mesenchymal cell into the cartilage. If the patient is a smoker, mesenchymal cell do not form that rapidly as it forms otherwise. If the patient is on a tobacco or is a chronic alcoholic abusive patient, then this early callus phase, that mesenchymal cell to the cartilage phase does not form. And inflammatory phase. Now, every injury has got an inflammatory phase. It is very important to understand this, that this inflammatory phase is prolonged in arthritic patients. Even our knife causes inflammatory phase. We get injury, it is an inflammatory phase. We get a fracture, this is the inflammatory phase. And what is the difference between a normal inflammatory phase and an abnormal inflammatory phase? Is the duration. And we say, very happily predict, oh, this will take 2 months. This will take 6 weeks. So the patient takes your words as a gospel truth. But beware of a patient who already has arthritic attacks like spine backache, knee pain, or some standard arthritic presentation elsewhere, these are the patients who will trouble you when you say, oh, 6 weeks, it is your ignorance. They will take 3 months or maybe even longer, because inflammatory phase in arthritic patient never or takes a long time to subside, and then the early callus phase starts. So when the first thing is not finishing, the second thing won't start. So this is the take home message for you today, that be aware of the arthritic patient who will refuse to take your treatment and internal fixation and bone grafting and whatnot. And they will give you a good name as well, because once you are able to put them back. Now, non-union, everybody wants to know a definition. Even the insurance company wants to know what is a non-union, sir. So for your definition purposes, defined as a no progress of union in 9 months, seen in a consecutive x-rays in 3 months, that every month progress of union in 9 months, every 3 months you should say the last x-ray is today's x-ray is no different from the last x-ray. So like that. Now there are 2-3 radiographic types. We all know, we are not discussing on it. We know this is a hypertrophic type, when the orthopedic surgeon say, oh, you have not done the proper fixation, so give a proper fixation, or you know, this is because of lack of fixation. But I will tell you, this is not lack of fixation. See, oligotrophic means this atrophic means poor vascularity. Oligotrophic is also a type of between the two. Now see, now this is the x-ray of a woman who is 70-year-old, had a subtrochanteric fracture. She is a known patient of arthritis, has been given a treatment of PFN. Initially she was given a treatment of PFN, which failed. I will tell you the history. No, this is Mrs. T.P. Vijayan, and in nutshell, where is that? Yes, patient of chronic spondyloarthritis with secondary osteoporosis with history of bisphosphonate intake. Sustains a subtrochanteric fracture managed by PFN, PFN August 2014. Now she has a failed implant managed by DHS in November 14. Now fracture refused to heal till 2016, and when she agreed for the final or the third surgery of bone grafting. But this time the wisdom prevailed, and she thought that I will take an opinion of another doctor. And she, her son who works in Gurgaon, came to see me that I want you to take the third surgery. So I said, studied her case and then said, she doesn't need a third surgery. The surgery has been done properly well. So why do you call it as a third surgery? No, doctor, she has waited enough, because 2014 and she has been on a walker. The site is still painful, and the doctors are telling that this implant will also fail. Now, charging jara sa kab ho gaya hai, bro. Anyway, let us continue that. So, क्या गायब हो गया? Now what happens, that I keep her on anti-arthritis medications, stop her bisphosphonate. She was already off her bisphosphonate, and add teriparatide to her to the list. And this is the picture what I get, and the support in the walking, she has discarded that, the fracture has healed, and she is happy with the present status, because she can walk without support. indoors, but when she is going out, she will take a stick which has been given to her. She is already 70 years and a chronic arthritic patient. So this is the patient who the last doctor was unable to understand why is this, because change in the implant will not augment healing. Dekho aaya. Yes. Osteoporotic fracture is an incidence during osteoporosis. It is bound to happen. Even if the patient falls from the chair, not from the standing height, even if she falls from the chair or while going to the washroom, she may have a dizzy spell and fall from the toilet seat, she can have a fracture because she was asking for it. She was already on a low, she is already an osteoporotic woman, a minor impact would have given this fracture. Now the fracture has happened and you are, there is very poor demand of the calcium, whatever calcium she has, she is already on a losing mode. Now she has developed a fracture as well. Now there is more demand of the calcium which will make her condition worse. And there is a very poor mobility of the calcium at the site. That is the reason is osteoporotic fracture. He will take bone grafts at the site because of the poor mobility of the calcium and protein to the site. So if you do the bone grafting at that site, they will be all right. I don't do a bone grafting because the fracture itself has given enough BMP in the material. You give some calcium hydroxypeptide or some artificial calcium at the local site and they will heal. Just alignment is the issue. So did not open this. This is a closed method of treating it. And someone will say, this has healed in a little bit of virus and this and that. Idealistic people, I agree to this. But what we need to give is an alignment so that the fracture which was in this condition has improved in this condition. And a U-slap given to this woman, closed wiring has been done, two from upper side and two from the lower side, and a tension band also done in a closed way. How to do it, we will discuss it individually when our younger friends will ask me. So I have not opened, only a hole up there, a small 1-2 millimeter hole down there, and this entirely fixation has been done so that our granny is at least pain free. Right, and add on teriparatide. Only 2 months of teriparatide. 3 months have been purchased for after 2 months. This has healed. We have taken the implant out. Implant has also been removed under local condition. So give a local instillation here and there. Pull the implant out, and you get a proper healing. But without giving teriparatide, osteoporotic fractures will not heal. Along with, this is an opportunity. This is a bad luck. I say it is a good luck that your mother was suffering from malnutrition. She sustains a fracture. She comes to see me. Now you get a proper diet for her, because whatever you have been feeding her is not the right food for her age. You give this blah blah blah, then this is a recipe for an old woman who has got a very selective absorption, and then she will get a proper healing of the fracture. So this is what my recommendation is. Now, when you say, this is, Prakash has been talking about orthopedics beyond books and a sort of thing, I say, holding your knife back and thinking for the benefit of the patient, whether it gives you monetary benefit or not, it's orthopedics beyond greed. And this should be our motto. Money is a byproduct of our experience and expertise. But orthopedics beyond greed is what the patient wants. If you can give slight little benefit to these elderly people who are suffering, then you are much ahead in your subject rather than having few more figures in your bank account. This is another patient, same thing. Now this is a patient comes with a left knee pain, crepitus and chronic synovitis, right IT fracture managed by the DHS. This time a DHS fails, followed by a PFN 3 years ago. Now peri implant osteoporosis. See, 3 years have been there, and a peri implant osteoporosis. So what I would suggest, get a BMD DEXA, and then kept the patient on DMARD and teriparatide, and the fracture heals well. So she has come again with a follow up that this is the status of my fracture, and she is walking without support. Then did not change the implant, everything is all right. The DHS was also all right, had the doctor realized what is the cause of her delayed union or implant failure. And this is the osteoporosis. You see that the osteoporosis level is more than 2.5, 3.8 in the spine and neck femur, all osteoporotic report, which is very handy. So you should give teriparatide, control the low grade arthritis if the ESR and CRP high, and she has got pain in the knee and arthritis is active. That means she is already suffering from active arthritis supported by secondary osteoporosis, delayed union and non-union, and the quality of the bone is absolutely poor. This is another patient. See, the condition is like this. This patient is already osteoporotic. Look at the fractured arthritic patient. See, this was done. Thank you very much. The surgeon was, this was a well-expected regime and the treatment. 26-11-17, did not unite, patient is unable to walk, and the attendants are going to the doctor every day. Now the doctor is feeling little jittery, he does not want to face the patient again. You see the peri-implant osteoporosis. He has done nothing wrong, this is ideally a good treatment he has given, but he doesn't know why this is not healing. Now he says that there is another surgery needed, that is bone grafting, which he has done the bone grafting. Now you can see those bone grafting here, bone grafts sitting here, but still the peri implant osteoporosis is there. There is no healing, patient cannot walk, simply she is literally on a walker, and the condition is miserable. Still not uniting. This is March 19. I have taken up this patient, kept her on teriparatide and anti-arthritis. The spine is badly spondyloarthritic, giving her indication. And within 2 months' time, this will be healing well. So, this is in short what has happened to the patient so far. But and miserable condition of this patient who is still walking 2 years down the line with the help of a walker. She cannot bear weight on that side. Implant failure is not there so far, but it may fail very soon if I don't intervene and augment the fracture healing. Because it's a recent case, I've taken up only a week ago. In 2 months' time, I'll post a new X-ray in the Ortho Global, and people can appreciate that. See, this is what the message I want to give to the young doctors. You do everything, whatever is possible, but still there are patients who are not ready to accept your blessings as a surgery. And there will be complaint that my surgery, that what he did, I don't know, but my patient is not walking. Right? Thank you so much. So this was about the first lecture in which we are facing these cases every day. Practically, someone or the other orthopedic surgeon is facing a similar condition where he is not getting a desirable result of fracture union in his patient. So this is the way to analyze it and take care that osteoporotic fracture is an incident in the course of osteoporosis. You have to reverse the osteoporosis, and then only there will be a healing of the fracture. Right? Thank you so much. Any questions, or we can go to the next slide.